Hello and welcome to our video assignment. We are mechanical engineering students of University of Malaya. Today, we are presenting our assignment project in basic material subject for mechanical engineering. Please give a comment and like down below to our video. The material that we have chosen for this project is aircraft that will be focused on the nose part. Every engineering need to have a basic knowledge on materials properties such as polymers, alloy, and steels. Thus, these materials will be likely used in manufacturing and processing to invent new inventions that can achieve certain goals. This fundamental knowledge is very important because engineering need to ensure that these materials are fit to implement on objects that can withstand external resistance, load, and also stability. In this project, we chose aircraft nose as our reference to find out the reasons and the type of material and its properties that are used by engineer. We are going to explain in depth about this object starting from its schematic diagram. This is the schematic diagram of the aircraft nose. This nose has a unique design and material. The material that is used to construct the nose is called pyrolytic carbon. What is pyrolytic carbon? According to Ming-Wei Chen, Yin-Bao Zhu, Jun Xia, Heng Anwu, pyrolytic carbon is the deposited carbon generated from the pyrolytic reaction of volatile hydrocarbon under high temperature. It can be used as the coatings of nuclear reactor fuel particles and the component of carbon composites for space vehicles like airplanes and helicopters. The importance of this material's properties, it is because of its microstructure. Next, we move on to the microstructure of the material. Pyrolytic carbon has a wide variety of microstructure. The first classification of it was presented by Gray and Cathcart. They presented three general types of microstructure, which are isotropic, rough lamina, smooth lamina, and columnar grain that can be seen through TEM. Lamina can be defined as a thin plate or scale. Columnar is defined as resembling an upright pillar or column. In other words, columnar in microstructure means that the particles are arranged in a vertical order. Granular microstructure can be defined as being composed of small spherical aggregates. It can also be used to describe small equine aggregates with an irregular or angular to subangular shape.
Next, Pearson and Lieberman did a study of this material and came out with three typically observed matrix microstructure, which are isotropic ISO exhibiting extension crosses, smooth lamina exhibiting well-defined extension crosses, rough lamina exhibiting numerous irregular extension crosses. Now, we are going to take a look at the development of microstructure. The process of deposition of pyrolytic carbon was deducted by analyzing the component of molecules in gas phase and observing the microstructure of deposition carbon. The first step of the decomposition of carbon is the breakdown of carbon-carbon single bond and forms two kinds of active groups in the heterogeneous gas phase reaction. Afterwards, these active groups form many stable bigger molecules and deposit on carbon fiber surface. At the same time, hydrogen atoms of the bigger molecules absorbed on carbon fiber surface are eliminated and the solid pyrolytic carbon matrix is formed in the heterogeneous reaction process. One example of pyrolytic carbon is vapor-grown carbon fibers, VGCFs. It is obtained by the decomposition of hydrocarbons at a very high temperature.
Any amorphous carbon that was present in the process was almost completely removed through an oxidization process. In terms of geometry, the extraordinary bundle formation would be due to the strong interaction between each nanofiber in the gas phase during the growth process. Furthermore, the possibility of bundle formation becomes higher under the condition of high flow rate of the carrier gas. Lastly, we are going to relate the microstructure with materials property. The density of pyrolytic carbon depends strongly on the deposition temperature. Although higher acetylene concentration also resulted in pyrolytic carbon with lower densities, in general, the effect of concentration was less pronounced than the effect of deposition temperature. There is a strong increase in the pore size and amount of porosity at higher deposition temperature. Pyrolytic carbon deposited at low temperatures had a uniform laminar structure with almost no apparent porosity, whereas the pyrolytic carbon deposited at high temperature showed a non-uniform structure with large spherical particles and large pores of about 0.1 to 5 micrometer. In terms of structural order, there are four different types of structures described in terms of the orientation angle, which is isotropic, low texture, medium texture, and high texture. At low deposition temperature, the pyrolytic carbon domains seems rather short and relatively well ordered. The opposite is observed at 1550 degrees Celsius with long graphene layers with many curvatures and carbon domains randomly distributed.